Hello friends and good day. This is Fred with Tech Talk and I'm coming at you today with a video on a Hikvision 5 megapixel fisheye camera. It's a 365 degree 5 megapixel IPPOE camera. It's got a 1.05 millimeter lens. So a very recessed lens that gives you a large field of view. The model number for this camera is DS-2CD2955FWD. Okay, it does give you 30 frames per second at 2560 x 1920. And again, 8 meter infrared. It's a neat camera. We're going to cover it right now. All right, let's get into the meat and potatoes. Before we do, you know the drill. There is a subscribe button in the bottom right hand corner of your screen. Please click that if you have not yet subscribed to our channel so you'll be notified when we upload future content. Also, like the video if the content is useful to you. And as always, leave comments. A lot of these videos are based on subscriber questions and comments. So yeah, let's get into it. All right, kids, when you remove these items from the Hikvision box, you will see there are two items inside. The first is the fisheye camera itself, and the second is a mounting bracket. Okay, there are several pigtails on this lead from the camera. Obviously, the most important and the one that most people will use is the Ethernet plug. This will be wired most likely to a PoE NVR or a PoE switch that will give the camera power and data. In the event that you do not have a PoE device, say you only have a standard Ethernet switch without PoE capabilities, this has a 12 volt pigtail that can be used with a regular 12 volt transformer, 12 volt 1 amp transformer. It has a pigtail for audio in and audio out in case you want to wire a mic with this. It has a pigtail also for alarm wiring. Okay, so there are quite a few pigtails, but for your standard installation, you're only going to worry about one of them. That is the Ethernet plug that will be plugged to your PoE switch. We also have the mounting bracket. Okay, there's a raised side and a flush side. The flush side is what you will mount to a wall or preferably with a fisheye camera to the ceiling, right? You want that full peripheral 365 view. And we are going to pull this up live and show you what that looks like. It's really a fascinating picture. So what you do is there are a couple of screws on this mount. You would mount, again, the flush side onto the ceiling or wall. Once that's mounted, you would run the pigtails through the hole in the bracket, like so. So you're pushing all those through there. Once you do that, there are some alignment arrows right here. You would push this into the alignment arrow, turn it, and it's locked into place. Okay. When you want to take it off, you just can't turn it off. There's a release clip. It says right there, push to unlock. If you push this and turn, you can unlock it from the mounting plate. Okay, what we're going to do now, I am going to take this mounting plate and the fisheye camera. I'm going to mount it kind of haphazardly in the living room to give you a perspective of the field of view on these guys, okay? So give me a chance and we'll do that right now. All right, so we have went and mounted the Hikvision fisheye in the living room area. It is connected to a PoE switch that has the uplink port plugged into our firewall. So right now the fisheye is active on our local network and it's also live on the internet. So what we're going to do now is we need to activate that camera. If you have watched previous Hikvision videos, you have undoubtedly heard us talk about the Hikvision SADP tool. This is a discovery tool for Hikvision's hardware. There is a link going across the screen right now in the event you have not yet downloaded this tool. So we're going to open up SADP. Sorry about that noise. And when we do, it is going to
locate any Hikvision hardware on our network. And right now, this camera, the 2CD2955FWD1S, that is our fisheye. So we want to activate that. As you can see, it's inactive. Once you click the box, it will prompt you to enter a administrative password for your camera. And you're going to have to type this and verify it. And once we do that, folks, we can activate the camera. There we have a pop-up with another annoying noise that says the device is activated. The next thing we want to do, all Hikvision cameras ship in static IP mode at the IP address of 192.168.1.64. My gateway is 192.168.0.1, not .1.1 like the camera. And yours may not be on the same gateway as the camera either. So what you want to do in any event is you also want to enable DHCP, and that will allow the camera to allow your routing device in your network to issue it an IP address on your gateway, and the camera will operate properly. Okay, so we'll do that. And in a second, the camera will change gateway. We'll see this change from 192.168.1.64 to 192.168.0-something. Let's refresh, and there we see 192.168.0.21. Once you have your camera on your gateway and you have enabled DHCP, we now want to click this and actually disable DHCP. The reason you want to do that, if you leave it in DHCP mode and you have a power outage or the camera reboots, it's possible that the routing device on your network will give it, will hand off another IP address. And if that happens, you won't be able to pull up the camera because you won't know the IP address change. So once you disable DHCP, it basically puts the camera back in static, but it gives it an IP address on your network. We also want to enable HIK Connect. That is Hikvision's phone app. It's a P2P app that will let you scan the barcode that was on the box of this camera, we showed you that earlier, into your phone app, and you pull up the camera no problem as long as you have this verification code. And you can put anything you want here. It does have to be 6 to 12 letters. I always put in the same password as the administrative password. I don't want too many passwords because I may get confused. I'm a simple guy. You can do what you want. Just remember, one is a verification code, and one is the administrative password. If you make them consistent in the same thing, which I do, you don't have to worry about it. It keeps it simple. So we'll go ahead and confirm that. We'll enter our password here. And we will take this camera out of DHCP mode and enable HIK Connect. And we have a message here saying that HIK Connect is enabled. Beautiful. Okay. So now what we can do is we can cut and paste our IP address, and we will pull this camera up in a browser. Okay. Oops, I messed that up, huh? Let's try that again. There we go. That's better. Now, when you open this up in a browser, this is something we've talked about before with Hikvision. It's not a favorite point of mine, but Hikvision equipment, Hikvision cameras and MVRs, for the most part, they need to be pulled up in Internet Explorer. You can't use Edge, you can't use Chrome, you can't use Firefox. You actually can use Edge, but it has to be in Explorer mode, and I'll explain more about that in a moment. You can also use Hikvision's IVMS 4200 client software. If you've seen our previous video on that, you know what I'm talking about. If you have not seen our video, I'd recommend watching it. There is a scroll going across the screen right now on how to download Hikvision's IVMS 4200 and how to use it. Okay, so we're going to pull it up in a browser, and I have actually upgraded my computer to Windows 11 already. So if you have Windows 11, you can no longer run Explorer. It's not an option. You have to run Edge in Explorer mode to get to this camera. Okay, so let's open up Edge. Okay, and again, our camera will paste 192.168.0.21. Okay, Now, this is important. Once you paste this, okay, what you want to do is you want to Control C again, and you want to cut this. And you're going to want to go into the Edge settings and allow Internet Explorer to run for this IP address. And how you do that, you click on here. We're going to go into settings. Okay. When we're in settings, you will see default browser right here. Okay. And it will tell you right here, are you facing issues in opening legacy sites? With Internet Explorer mode, you can open legacy sites in Microsoft Edge. Select add under Internet Explorer mode pages. So if we come down here, we can hit allow here. Okay. We want to allow sites to reload in Internet Explorer. And then we want to tell it what page. Okay. So we want to add, and then we want to add the link to our camera. Okay. Simple as that. Okay. Hit paste. And Dale, you'll see it. Okay. Right there. So now, when there's no save button or anything, by the way, with Edge. But now when we try to log into this, we'll actually refresh the page here, folks. It will allow you to log into a Hikvision camera using Edge. A lot of stuff, I know. I do prefer Dahua. I've installed Hikvision for a decade and a half, and recently switched over to Dahua for a couple of projects. And one of the features that I love is that you can pull up a Dahua camera, NVR, DVR, in any browser. No plugins needed, it's beautiful. You can also download video from a Dahua, NVR, DVR, and play it right back in Windows Media Player. Whereas with Hikvision, depending on the model of NVR, oftentimes you have to convert the file from H.264 or H.265 to an AVI file that can play in Media Player. So sorry about that tangent. But yeah, this is what you see. This is a fisheye camera, folks, if you've never seen one. I am not a huge fan. I kind of like them in a cash register area in a store, convenience store. It gives you an overview of the whole area. Okay. One thing that is kind of cool are the different views that you can set up. As you see, there's a display mode. There's also a mount type. Let's talk about that. This is ceiling mounted, okay, in the living room. You could also wall mount it, or you could desktop or table mount it, okay? And based on how it's mounted, it would change your view, okay? So, our display mode. Okay, there's different display modes, and you could go through them all. This is kind of groovy. Changes it into a big bubble where you have both sides, you know, looks like on a curved wall, whereas it's really an open space, as you can see here. But there are different views, and then people like different things. The one that I really like is right here, okay? It's down in the bottom row to the left. You see the circle and the three squares. The reason I like this, right, is you can customize it. If you click on the actual fisheye camera, there are different squares, and you can move them around. You can put it on the kitchen, which is kind of messy after the holiday, I guess. Up here on the top, say we wanted this on the sliding door right there. We could do that. If you double-click into this picture pane, you can actually move it further. Okay, so there's that. Why my kid's scooter's inside the house, I'll never know about. There we go. The blue would be the bottom, right? That could be the living room, you know? Or if I wanted the door, I don't know if I get the door in the living room with this camera the way. Yeah, there you go. Could put that in the door and the window if you wanted to. Okay? But basically, you can customize your views and do the playback. So you get the 360 angle, which again, some people like, some people don't. But you also have more of a standard view for the other cameras, okay? So that's Fisheye 101, right? We talked about when we unboxed the product that there is a mini SIM card that you can insert into the camera for storage, okay? In other words, it does not have to be plugged into a NVR or a DVR to record, okay? So to playback, again, there's a link going across the screen right now. We've covered playback with Hikvision cameras and a million different videos. But you just hit the playback button. You pick your day. We just put this in today for this video. Hit search, and then you can scroll to your time frame. Okay, we did not set this up for motion. It's continually recording. So if we scroll, and hit play. Sure enough, we're playing back, and it's working because that's me and I'm talking to y'all. So you can also do the same thing I showed you with the mini screens during playback, which is kind of neat. This is before we adjusted them, but that's how it works. Of course, you can take snapshots. If I hit the right button there, you can take snippets. The scissors, take a video snippet if you like. When you then it will give you the link, you know, to where that put that, and that's archived to your computer forever. So that's it. That's like I said, fisheye 101. They're a different type of camera. They're kind of neat. Again, from an ROI, I do not recommend them for our clients very often. It would have to be, you know, a front-end cash register type of situation, or a customer that requests the camera because they like it. These guys are over $300, around the $300 range, and you could get a good 4-megapixel dome camera for the inside of a location for, you know, $125 or $150. So I don't see the return on investment, again, unless it's a front-end. So hopefully you enjoyed the video. We'll see you in the field.